Senior.
Yeah, I've got a
veteran. Melissa McDonald.
Thank you.
Junior Brooke Nicholson. Junior Emma Pitcock. Junior Ava Rinderneck. Junior Sydney Rinderneck. Junior Sarah Shepherd. Senior veteran All-American and co-captain Samantha Torres. Senior veteran All-American Shay Van Cleve. Junior Lauren Villarreal. Senior Shannon Woolsey. And the sophomore mascot, Grayson Snyder, as Coco the Cougar. The cheer is coached by Angie Eller. The cheerleader of the week is Shay Van Cleve. Cheer Officer Orion Jones. Junior Jalindra Bullock. Senior Spirit Officer Nancy Torres. Junior Shayon Lewis. And Junior Stephanie Alcoser. And the one, the only, Rambo. The Spirit Cheerleader of the Week is Cassie Sura. The Mayde Creek High School cheerleaders are under the direction of varsity coach Kathy Fuller and JV coach Sarah Baller. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and we now turn our attention to the Cinco Ranch Band as they play the Cinco Ranch School Song. Let's pay attention to the Mayde Creek Band as they play Mayde Creek School Song.
Well, a big hello and welcome everybody into Texan Live's coverage of high school football presented by TexanDrive.com. We're coming at you live from Rhodes Stadium in Katy, Texas in this matchup featuring the Mayde Creek Rams and the Cinco Ranch Cougars. I am Mark M. Johnson, joined alongside me, Derek Jones, and as always, an absolute pleasure to bring you the game live here on TexanLive.com. And hey, if you'd like to know more about Texan Live, feel free to check out the rest of our website for articles, archive games, archive highlights, and a whole heck of a lot more we got here. And you can follow us on social media, Twitter and Instagram, Texan_Live. And you can also follow us on our Facebook page, Texan Live, as well. We'll pause moments to recognize America with the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand for the national anthem and the presentation of the colors? Tonight's honor guard is under the command of Cadet Senior Chief River Artiaga. The color guard is under the command of Cadet Petty Officer Fernando Durant. And the national anthem will be played by the Mayde Creek High School Band.
Well, there you have it, Mayde Creek with their rendition of the Star Spangled Banner, the band getting it going here. Once again, I'm Mark M. Johnson, alongside with me Derek Jones, production engineer Jesse Wolf, And we got a heck of a game here for you tonight. Right now, I think that everybody's considering Cinco Ranch to be number two in the slot right now. Mayde Creek coming out of the dark. They got an 0-5 record, I believe, isn't it?
Yes, they do.
So, and of course, Cinco Ranch is undefeated. They're in this district with Katie. They're in this district with Seven Lakes and Katie Taylor. There's going to be a lot of dogfights coming out of this. So, a lot of anticipation coming in tonight. Derek, what do you got?
Well, I'm looking forward to an exciting matchup. I mean, I understand that Mayde Creek hasn't had the success that they want to have. Cinco is one of the teams, of course, fighting with Katie for that top spot, but more importantly for them, more than likely second and third place spot with Seven Lakes. But after that game last night with Seven Lakes and Tompkins, we'll have to see how that pans out. But Mayde Creek's a young team. They want to have some success. I mean, I know they look forward to playing the big dog, so to speak, of the district and of the conference. So I'm looking for a spirited effort, to say the least, from Mayde Creek tonight.
Almost blown away by that. You and I talking before the game about Seven Lakes falling to Tompkins 21-20. It's peculiar. I mean, it's something that you don't necessarily expect, but it's football, and especially it's high school football. You're going to see things like that all the time, and there's no reason that you look at the record of Mayde Creek and Cinco Ranch, and there's no reason that Mayde Creek couldn't possibly come away with a victory in this one.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I mean, you play the game. I mean, you come out here and you compete. Anything can happen. I mean, miscues can take place. I mean, you can be emotionally excited about the game and change the outcome. I mean, no, on paper it may show one thing, but you have to play the game. That's what they always say. And just like Tompkins last night when they upset, kind of an upset to Seven Lakes, I'm sure that a lot of folks wouldn't have expected that, but that's why you play the games. You play hard, and you just kind of let it rest where it rests. So Mayde Creek has every opportunity to come out here and have some success. They've had some offensive success this year. I'm looking forward to seeing the young man Donovan Lee at running back. He actually leads the district right now in rushing. You would think that with the success that Katie has, you would think Porter would be the leading rusher, but it's actually Mayde Creek, Donovan Lee, who's leading the conference. So, I mean, they have some positive things that they can look up to and look forward to. I would not take it lightly for Cinco Ranch to come out here and compete. Mayde Creek is definitely going to give a good showing, and anything can happen.
About ready for kickoff here, back in the backfield, ready to receive the kickoff. Devontae Watson is out there on the left side. Here's the kick. It's going to go to the left side, taken by Xavier Shelton. He's going to fumble that ball out of bounds around the 3-yard line. Tough start for Mayde Creek.
That's definitely not the start you want to have. I mean, especially when you want to come out and have some success and maybe beat a team that may be a little bit more imposing than you are. The last thing you want to do is start deep in your own end. That play can come back to start this game off in a bad position for Mayde Creek.
Well, they're going to officially put that ball around the 5-yard line. Not exactly the way they probably wanted to start off the momentum here in the beginning stages. Nonetheless, they do have the ball first, are the Rams, and ready to go to work. Quarterback's going to keep it himself. He's actually going to lose about 3 or 4 yards on that one, forced out of bounds.
Yeah, you're attempting to try a jet formation to the right-hand side. When you're this close to the end zone, you really want to line up in your two tight formation, just try to get some yards out of the deepness of your own end zone. To give your punter an opportunity, you know, to get some field position. Kind of risky play starting off the game.
Absolutely. Anthony Alcazar on that carry. He is 20 for 45 this season, 245 yards in the air, 3 touchdowns and 2 interceptions. Here's the next play. Maybe good for a yard or two on that play.
Brought down by Jesse.
And Austin Simmons was assisting on that tackle. The carries by Donovan Lee. Like I say, looking forward to seeing that young man work tonight. He seems like he's a pretty good young man running the ball.
Amazing, after you hear the night that Kyle Porter had last night, you would naturally assume he's a leading rusher, but like you said, Derek, Mayde Creek doing the groundwork this season. Not even a minute has gone by here in the first quarter. No score at Rhodes Stadium, Katie. Mayde Creek in their greens looking to throw this one. Alcazar looking downfield, and that ball's going to be picked off around the 40-yard line. Taken to the 30 and now dragged down around the 24-yard line in Mayde Creek territory. Cinco Ranch forcing an early turnover.
Big interception by Jacob Smith, number 7. Quarterback went back and threw it up, put a little bit too much air under it. Nice play, nice ball position from Jacob Smith to come away with the grab. Caught the ball at his highest points.
No, Mayde Creek, not necessarily a team that throws very much, but they went for a big one there on third and long. Unfortunately for them, they turn the ball over and give Cinco Ranch great field position. So the Cougars at the 24-yard line will have a first and 10. There's the first hike. Up the middle, he's not going to be touched into the end zone for the first score of the game. Cinco Ranch is on the board. Davion Johnson with the score.
Option read, dive to the left-hand side, off tackle, untouched to the end zone. Like I said, not the way Mayde Creek wanted to start tonight's ball game.
It didn't even look like he was touched. I mean, it seemed like he just kind of walked his way through there for a minute and didn't see any bounces or anything.
Yeah, anytime you get linemen up to the second and third levels, there's not going to be very many people left to try to bring them down.
In for the PAT. It didn't take him long to get this scoring going. Cinco Ranch is going to kick that one through for the PAT. 7-0 Cinco Ranch atop Mayde Creek early here at Katy. 10:50 left. You're listening and watching TexanLive.com. Well, Cinco Ranch took an early 7-0 lead thanks to a turnover, an interception, and then a 24-yard run by the running back as this one is kicked back over the head this time of Xavier Shelton in for a touchback.
And as always, I have my keys to the game, and it's already started. For Mayde Creek, I always come up with they need to have something positive happen early, and that's one check that didn't take place. Need to find a groove with Lee. Need to take some shots deep, which they attempt to do that, and that didn't work out as well. Right early, play with emotion. Don't let Cinco Ranch intimidate you before this game gets started. Don't get discouraged if the big play happens, and try to limit the mental mistakes. And already three or four of those are already checked off in the negative box.
And certainly they have been. Let's see if they can overcome that. Here's a run to the outside. Now past the 30, onto the 35, and that looks like a first down. The run made by Jaylen Brown.
Brought down by Reggie. And that's a nice bounce out run by Jaylen Brown to the outside, to the right hand side. Gives Mayde Creek a first down. Definitely you want a positive play coming in after Cinco just put the touchdown on the board.
Definitely a positive side here up to the 39 yard line. Their first down of the game. 10:40 still left in the first quarter. It's early. Quarterback's going to take it himself. He was going all the way. He's going to pick up maybe 4 yards on the play.
Jaylen Brown on the carry. Brought down by Austin Simmons.
Jaylen Brown with the carry. Jaylen Brown has 3 rushing touchdowns this season. Here's a quick pass over to the outside, completed, and getting a pretty decent gain there, up close to the first down.
Austin Simmons is on the tackle as well. Simple X quick play out to the left-hand side, just trying to get your receivers on there, cornerbacks as fast as you can, get your wide receiver in some space, attempt to try to get as many yards as you can to try to set up short yardage on third down.
Sean McConico with the reception on that one. That brings third and one now. All close to midfield on the 48-yard line in Mayde Creek territory. Here's a snap, and it's going to go to Brown again. He's going to get a first down and a few more yards into the territory of Cinco Ranch. He's got himself a first down.
That's a nice carry. I thought I saw a flag being thrown. If that's the case, it happened really quick. Usually you get holding calls when the referee throws a flag that fast as the play started.
That's definitely going to go against Mayde Creek. Repeat third down after the illegal formation.
That's always a tough play. Usually when you have your receivers go out to the wide receiver spot, of course they look at the referee to make sure they're on side, but they also have to make sure that end man on the line of scrimmage is on the line of scrimmage. Key play for the offense to always check that to make sure you're not in the backfield.
So now they're going to have to try the third down again. This time they're backed up 5 yards at their own 43. Here's the snap, and it's a handoff going up the middle and spinning his way close to a first down, but he's not going to get it. A yard or two shy is Donovan Lee.
And Austin Simmons coming in from the safety spot to make that play.
Fourth down.
What is going to be 2 yards short of the first down up to the 47-yard line. Not much of a change going on in the huddle. They're probably going for it. What do you think about this, Derek?
It's a short yardage play. I mean, you want to stay in the game, maybe try to get the defense to jump off sides. I would have gone for it.
So here they go, the handoff over to the outside, and it's going to work out in their favor. First down, a little more into the territory of Cinco Ranch once again. This time taking it once, actually taking it again was Donovan Lee.
And a nice play call, a delayed draw. Lee bounced out to the left-hand side. I mean, he's like I said, he's leading the league in rushing. I mean, he's an outstanding running back. It appears he has some outside quickness to bounce it outside to get the first down for Mayde Creek. Nice play, first down.
Even when he was in trouble in the back, managed to work his way out of that and just sprint to the outside and get that first down. So the ball up to the 44-yard line, Cinco Ranch territory. Another handoff. And not getting much on this one is going to be stopped up. Brown still on his feet. My goodness. Fights his way back probably to the line of scrimmage. May have gotten a yard on that, but it could have been a lot worse.
That's a great second effort. Andrew Ngueta made the tackle for Cinco Ranch. Young man kept his legs moving, kept his body position low. That was a nice move, nice drive from that young man at the running back position.
So here's an early timeout taken by Cinco Ranch. We'll step aside for a moment. It's 7-0 Cinco Ranch here in the early stages in the first quarter. You're watching TexanLive.com.
Star State. The best part? It's a short drive from Houston and minutes from the Energy Corridor. With places to stay and places to play, anything you'd like to eat, and an old town charm that can't be beat. Activities and fun for the entire family. Enjoy the best of both worlds in the City of Champions, Katy, Texas. For more information, go to cityofkaty.com.
Back here at Rhodes Stadium in Katy, Texas, it's a 7-0 Cinco Ranch lead on top of Mayde Creek. Mayde Creek working with a 2nd and 10. And here it is, taking it himself up the middle to around the 37-yard line.
Brought down in part by Andrew Ngueta.
I'm also going to give Cole Rice, number 46, some assistance on that play. Nice jet formation. Feels they're running the pistol formation, and they're trying to get the safeties to back up with that jet formation. It's a nice play call.
Jalen Brown picks up some much-needed yards for this third down situation. A gain of 6 makes it 3rd and 4. Ball on the 38-yard line. Taking it himself once again, but not going to get the first down. Actually, he's going to probably lose yardage, was Jalen Brown. Another fourth down coming up.
Tackle made by Jesse Amore.
So the loss makes it 4th and 7. About halfway through this first quarter. Once again, they're going to go for it on 4th down. They're going to go to the air this time, and they're going to air it out. 2 receivers there, and he manages to make the catch. What an incredible catch over there by Xavier Shelton. Comes down with it inside the 10 near the 5-yard line. They're going to have a 1st and goal.
That was a big play. Anthony, a closer junior, reared back and threw it deep. That was a nice play. Went up to catch the ball at his highest point. That is a big play. Mate Creek needed that play to take place early in this game to get back in this ball game.
What a gutsy play on 4th and 7. Double covered. Manages to come away with it. And here's a 1st and goal situation on the 8-yard line. Taking it to the outside. Now losing his footing around the 10. Trying to cut it back in was the running back, Donovan Lee. And he's going to lose a couple yards on that.
See, they're trying to utilize Lee at more of kind of a scat back position. I mean, he's more agile and quicker than I anticipated. So Mayde Creek's trying to get him on the outside.
So here comes the 2nd and goal. Ball pushed back to the 10-yard line now. 1 in motion. They're not going to hand it to him. And keeping it himself once again is Brown. He's going to the outside. Stiff arms one of them and actually loses the ball. Trying to stiff arm him. Ball eventually rolls out of bounds around the 11-yard line. Another 1-yard loss, but luckily for him, that ball went out of bounds and not into the arms of one of the Cougars.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. That's a lucky bounce. I mean, you're trying to fight for those extra yards, but you definitely want to put 2 hands on the ball. Yeah, he's basically said that the ball was spotted where it ended up on the fumble. But definitely want to put 2 hands on the ball, especially down here. You want to get points out of this possession.
Especially after the big play that they had. So here's a 3rd and goal from the 13-yard line. Trying to find some room to run, but he's not going to get any. So they start on the 8-yard line, and 3 consecutive plays they lose yardage on, and they're going to be backed up to the 15-yard line on a 4th and goal situation.
Yeah, you got your big linebacker, Cole Rice, coming from the outside. Sometimes as a coach, you kind of overthink, what you're trying to do. I mean, you're on the 10-yard line. You want to come with some basic stuff, try to get the ball, try to get a 1st down, get close as you can, of course, for your field goal. Sometimes you outthink yourself by trying to be too cute when you need an opportunity to score.
So as opposed to going for 3 points, they're going to go for it all. Once again, why not? They've converted 2 of them. Going to the end zone. That ball looks high, and it's going to be caught. Is that a touchdown? It is. A touchdown caught in the arms of Jalen Brown. It's going to get Mayde Creek on the board.
That was a heck of an individual play by Jalen Brown. The actual defender had position, inside position, but Jalen Brown went up over him and caught the ball at his highest point, as we said earlier. That's a big play. Definitely Mayde Creek is excited about that. They needed that early in this game.
So an extra point away from tying this game. Wow. Here it is, left footer, gets it up and through. We have ourselves a tie ball game, 7-7 with 4:10 left in the first quarter. You're watching TexanLive.com. Well, it's a brand new ball game. 7-7 is your score. 4-10, Mark M. Johnson here with Derek Jones and production engineer Jesse Wolf. That was fourth down, three times they converted on to get that touchdown. Here's the kickoff. It's going to be taken around the 24-yard line by Cinco Ranch. And he's going to get a few yards on that as a flag goes up after the play was over with, taken up by Brance Cuthi. So Cinco Ranch will head back out onto offense. Their second drive of the game. They've only needed one play to get their points on offense. Still waiting for an official word from the flag. You see that was an illegal block there, Derek?
Yeah, illegal block in the back. You get that a lot of times on the kickoff return. I mean, guys are running down the field full speed, and you're trying to, in most cases, stand in front of them, and you know, you're trying to get that right angle, and you never know what the running back is doing behind you, so sometimes you get caught exposed with a hand in the back or trying to grab a jersey at the last second.
That penalty puts them at the 23-yard line in their own territory. Quarterback takes it himself, actually loses his footing for a moment. That might have cost him some good yardage there. It looked like he had some good room ahead of him, but taken down in the backfield. Maybe a one-yard gain on the play was the quarterback for Cinco Ranch, Russell Morrison.
And he was taken down by Jalen Brown. The young man's playing both ways. He's having a heck of a game so far.
Well, Morrison setting up to throw. He's got a man, completes it, a short pass. Takes it to about the 33-yard line. Well, close to a first down. It's going to be a little short.
It was a nice tackle from the safety position. Kevin Lasky came up to make that tackle. It appears May Creek is flying around early tonight.
Williams with that catch makes it third and one. Just about 3 minutes left here in the first. Here's the snap. Running back takes it up. He's got the first down, a little more. Close to midfield, out of bounds, just shy of the 50-yard line was a running back for the Cougars, Davion Johnson.
That's a nice off-tackle play to left-hand side. Down Johnson bounced out to the left-hand side to give Cinco Ranch a big first down. They need that, too, to calm down the emotion early in this game.
Well, now the ball on the 48-yard line. Cinco Ranch still in their own territory. Johnson makes it past midfield, now into Mayde Creek territory. Picks up about 8 on that play.
Johnson on the carry. Brought down in part by Dominic Gates and Nicholas Crawford. Second down, 2.
Davion Johnson has 47 attempts before this game. He had 253 yards and 6 touchdowns up to this point for the undefeated Cougars. Morrison's going to take it himself here. Gets a good block on the outside. Stays on his feet. Gets the first down. Heck of a lot more. Out bounds around the 34-yard line.
That was a nice block by his big wide receiver out there to give him some extra yards to get that first down. Keep the chains moving for Cinco Ranch.
Some Larry Fitzgerald-esque blocking on the other end.
Yeah, definitely key for your wide receivers to block for you.
Fresh set of downs for the Cougars. Morrison's going to hand it off to Johnson. He's going to look to the outside again. He's going to have one block and another first down for the Cougars. They're moving the ball around very well now.
Yeah, it's exactly what Cinco wants to do. They want to line up and kind of impose their will. Another one of my keys to the game. They need to run the ball early and often. Go ahead and impress to the point to Mayde Creek that you're going to run the ball and you're going to run the ball all night, and there's nothing they can do about it. That's the mindset you want to set if you're Cinco Ranch.
So from the 23-yard line, Morrison's going to run it again. He gets up probably to the original line of scrimmage.
Nice tackle by 34, Joshua Thomas coming up. eventually Mayde Creek's going to have to start getting some inside penetration if they want to slow this run down.
No doubt. The Cougars moving the ball down the field seemingly with ease right now. They're going to go to the air this time, though. Pass is behind the intended receiver. It looked like Grant Kuth once again.
And Cameron Arondo was out there with nice coverage on the play. Pass is a little bit behind. And I'm noticing that the defensive line, they were actually crabbing on the defensive line. That's a technique used to try to slow down the run to kind of cause a traffic jam right there at the line.
Morrison doesn't go to the air too much. 25 completions out of 46 attempts this year. Does have two touchdown passes and an interception. He's going to run it himself. And he's going to get out to about the 16-yard line.
Tackled by Kevin Lasky once again, number 12. That's a nice run by Morrison, setting up a short fourth down situation.
Now we know their kicker can get the ball through those uprights, but they're going to opt to go for it here on fourth and three, under a minute now left in the first quarter.
That was a good timeout by Mayde Creek. They actually had two receivers up top, only one defender out there. Miscommunication on their defensive setup.
The Rams want to take a minute to talk it over. 49 seconds left in the first quarter. It's a tie game, 7 apiece. You're watching TexanLive.com.
Come enjoy the heart of Katy, Texas, one of the most delightful cities in the Lone Star State. The best part? It's a short drive from Houston and minutes from the Energy Corridor. With places to stay and places to play. Anything you'd like to eat, and an old town charm that can't be beat. Activities and fun for the entire family. Enjoy the best of both worlds in the City of Champions, Katy, Texas. For more information, go to cityofkaty.com.
So the quick timeout by the Rams. They're ready to go here on defense. It's fourth and three situation. Morrison's going to hand the ball off, and they're not going to get it. It doesn't appear. The Rams hold the Cougars here with 44 seconds left in the first quarter. Turnover on downs. Mayde Creek's going to get the ball.
That's a big stop by Kelton Mangrum. Cinco Ranch, of course, did the right thing, in my opinion, of a team that you're supposed to get after pretty good. You want to go out and establish the tone early. I know you could have taken the field goal opportunity, but short yardage like that, you expect your guys, you work hard all week, you expect to come out and get that first down. But that's a nice stop by Mayde Creek. That's a big momentum change early in the game. Last thing you want to do is let a team that feels like they may not have an opportunity stay in the game.
For sure, especially the way they're moving the ball down the field as well. Here's a run to the outside, good for about 5 or 6 yards. And that was Lee once again with the carry.
That was a nice jet sweep once again to the left-hand side. Definitely appears Mayde Creek wants to try to get that young man out in some space and kind of let his athletic ability take over.
It'll be a second and four situation. Ball up to the 21-yard line in Mayde Creek territory. 20 seconds left on the clock. Alcazar takes it up the middle himself. May have gotten a yard.
Colin Poy, big number 42, plugged up that play to give him a short loss on that play.
Well, it looks like we're going to have yet another timeout down on the field. So, well, I'm sorry, that's the end of the first quarter. I wonder why everybody's going off the field like that. That takes us to the end of the first. It's 7-7 here at Rhodes Stadium. You're watching TexanLive.com.
Big Star Ford, Houston's fastest growing Ford dealer. Why? Huge discounts, most for your trade. Explorer, $6,000 off. Fusion, $7,000 off. F-150, $12,000 off.
F-250, $15,000 off. And now every car, truck, and SUV has 0% interest for 72 months. 0% for 72 months. Don't walk, run. These deals end soon. Big Star Ford, big city discounts, small town dealing.
One quarter is in the books. Welcome back into TexanLive.com. Mark M. Johnson with Derek Jones and production engineer Jesse Wolf. Second quarter about to get underway. It's a third and two situation for Mayde Creek. And here's the first play of the second quarter. The flag is down after the play. The run made by the Rams is going to get close to the first down, but it looks like it's going to be just shy.
Not sure on the flag. I mean, it's a little bit later. I mean, they could always call holding in a situation like that, but usually it comes in a face mask, maybe a personal foul, an intentional face mask when you're trying to make a tackle.
Referee's still talking it over. It's got to be something like that, I would imagine, Derek, that late of a throw.
Yeah, well, you have the running back, Jaylen Brown, he's running hard, and you're trying to make that tackle and you're trying to reach for something, and a lot of times when the running back has his head down, you end up unintentionally grabbing the face mask.
That is the case. A personal foul is going to go against the Cougars. So the Rams with fantastic field position now. Here's the first down for them. Pass is completed over around the 42-yard line. Actually only a pickup of about two, look like.
Nice tackle by a big linebacker, Cole Rice. And Mayde Creek has a good game plan started out right now. Quick routes, trying to get the ball out to your playmakers in space. Seems to be successful so far.
They're definitely coming into this game with confidence, I must say. They're hanging in there tight and they're playing strong. Here's another run up the middle, and it's going to be another first down for Mayde Creek.
That's a nice hard-nosed run, an off-tackle play to the right-hand side. I mean, these running backs, they seem to be determined to give that Mayde Creek offense an opportunity to be successful tonight. I'm really impressed so far with the young running backs that they had. I mean, every one of them that comes in, I mean, they're rotating. Each one of them coming in full speed when they're running the ball.
Absolutely. Sean McConico actually hasn't gotten very many reps so far in this game compared to the other running backs, but gets the first down there for the Rams. Here's the next play. Another handoff coming from the outside, getting him maybe 2 yards.
I think the ball came out on that.
Duncan Lee on the carry, tackled by Cole Wright.
You're right, Derek. Ball comes loose. Cinco Ranch recovers it around the 46-yard line, their own territory, 47-yard line. That's unfortunate for Mayde Creek. It looked like they had everything going in their favor, but as we just saw, Cinco Ranch looked like they had everything going in their favor on their previous drive.
Yeah, that's tough for Mayde Creek. I mean, you're coming out, you're establishing the run, you're establishing some type of momentum. You don't want to give the ball right back to Cinco and give them an opportunity to get fired up.
Can't imagine Cinco Ranch will make the same mistake twice, going to the air, guy wide open. Tripped up around the 38-yard line. The pass was completed to Jordan Anakua.
Yeah, that was a simple 15-yard in route. I mean, wide open. You had another outside receiver to run off the cornerbacks, and it allowed him to come underneath the 15-yard in. Nice play.
So that big game to the 34-yard line in Mayde Creek territory. Johnson takes it up on first and 10. Gets a good chunk of yards there. Picks up about 5 or 6.
Cameron Arondo is one of the men on the tackle. It's a nice run, nice first down run from Cinco Ranch. This is exactly how you want to answer. You want to come down and start to impose that will that you hadn't been able to do thus far.
Mayde Creek still trying to hold strong, but Cinco Ranch has been moving this ball rather well. And how long can the Rams hold that up? Johnson jumps over the pile. Probably picks up about 2 on the play.
Brings up third down.
You had big Jonathan Coleman, 33, coming off that left-hand side on the outside blitz, trying to crash in from the left-hand side, but he just missed the running back for a loss in the backfield.
So that'll make it third and three. Morrison headed to the outside. He's being chased. A nice spin move by him. He's tripped up, though, on the spin, but it looks like it was enough effort to get the first down.
Nice tackle by Kelton Mangrum. And once again, I see the defensive lineman for Mayde Creek. They're using that crab technique on the floor. I mean, it's good, like I say, to stop the make a pile in front of the line, but you don't have your hands to make the tackle. That's the only bad thing.
A new set of downs, a pass completed around the 4 or 5 yard line. Another first down, and Cinco Ranch is going to have first and goal.
That was a nice post route. Appears Mayde Creek is in cover two, and anytime you run cover two, that middle is always open.
So here's their first and goal attempt, and it's in the end zone for a touchdown. That pass completed. Brent Cuthy with a touchdown reception from Russell Morrison, and that puts Cinco Ranch back on top, 13-7.
That's a nice X out route. Have your wide receiver, usually your X or your Z, either one. One runs off and the other one runs underneath. That's a nice pass completion from Morrison to Cuthy. Nice response from Cinco.
PAT is up and good. 14-7 is your score with 8:46 left in the half. You're live, we're live at Katy and watching TexanLive.com. Well, a touchdown pass by Cinco Ranch makes it a 14-7 game here. Mayde Creek with the turnover around midfield ended up costing them 7 points in the end. So here comes the kickoff from Cinco Ranch. It's going to bounce around the 11-yard line, kind of die around there, and it's picked up. And there's a return. Oh, and he almost got away with that last-second tackle there Mayde. Shelton with the kickoff return almost got away.
Yeah, that was a touchdown-saving tackle, and that would have been a huge play for Mayde Creek to get back in the ballgame. What they want to do now is make sure they come out and get back to what they were doing. Of course, you don't want to have any turnovers. You want to continue to run Brown and Lee, get them the ball, keep that momentum going. You want to answer what Cinco Ranch has just done to you.
Ben Nealon perhaps with a game-saving play there for the time being for the Cougars. So now working just inside the 35-yard line, trying to get some yardage to the outside, but losing lots of yardage on that play was the quarterback for Mayde Creek, Alcazar.
Yeah, Cole Rice again and company on that tackle. Definitely have to make sure that Mayde Creek is not trying to overthink themselves. Just once again, get back to what you were doing. You were having some success with that. Don't try to get, in this, as we say, cute in this position.
Well, that definitely cost them there. 7-yard loss makes it 2nd and 12. There's one in motion. He's going to get it. He's headed to the outside, but they're going to realize that he's over there. He picks up a few yards. Still can't get back to the original line of scrimmage, though.
And the defensive pursuit from Cinco Ranch is starting to starting to catch up to that jet formation. The only thing about that, you don't want to run jet, you know, over and over again, because after a while, defense will start reading their keys and they'll just start taking off to the outside. And when you have a team like Cinco Ranch that can run pretty good, I mean, it makes it hard sledding to get to that outside.
Well, five-yard gain makes it third and 12. They're going to go to the air again and air it out. He's got a man down there, almost picked off.
Pass knocked down by Austin Simmons. Quarterback put a lot of air underneath that ball.
Grant Pfeiffer was the intended receiver. Almost got it over to him. A good play by the Cinco Ranch defense to hold him there and prevent yet another long pass. So fourth and 12 situation, they're going to have to punt it. It's a hard punt, and it looks like it's going to take a good bounce. It certainly does inside the 20, and that's going to trickle down probably inside the 10.
Oh, that was a great punt.
Down over at the 9-yard line. Nice line drive punt by the Mayde Creek special teams, puts Cinco Ranch with a lot of ground to cover now.
Mayde Creek's defense has been flying around early tonight. Although they're down, they have been flying around. They want to continue to keep that energy and keep the pressure on Cinco Ranch as long as possible. The longer this game is close, the more opportunity they're going to have to pull off an upset tonight.
Russell Morrison has 415 yards through the air so far this season. He's going to try to use his legs in this one. We've seen him use his legs a lot more than his arm in this game.
And big Calvin Lasky once again on the tackle. Morrison almost fumbled that ball, and that's exactly what I was trying to say. You want to make sure you keep it as close as possible, because then mistakes will take place, and it magnifies the importance of each possession more and more. So Mayde Creek wants to continue that intensity that they have right now.
Morrison actually with more rushing attempts this season than anybody on the team. He's got 54 attempts. Next guy closest to him is Johnson with 47. As we see Johnson take it up the middle and not get too much out of that.
Nice play from number 11, Jalen Brown, coming up.
So a third and 12 coming up, halfway through the second quarter now. Morrison does have 183 yards on the ground this season. He's looking to throw. He's hit as he's thrown, so that one's going to fall and bounce in front of his intended receiver.
Now, that's a big hit in the end zone, but that did not look like any kind of a personal foul.
Just a good play by the defense for the Rams. Are they actually going to say that was a personal foul?
Yeah, they're saying that it was a late hit roughing the passer, but it looked like it was almost simultaneous as the quarterback threw the ball.
Wow. Well, I'm not a referee. Maybe they know more than I do.
Yeah, he's actually from behind. The angle that he had, you know, it would appear that that would have been a intentional hit, but he was actually on time with that hit, in my opinion.
Well, unfortunately for the Rams, it goes down as a personal foul. So first and 10, pass from Morrison to Corey Rowe, and that's incomplete. It'll be second and 10.
That was a big play against Mayde Creek. Once again, that would have been a fourth down play. You know, getting the ball deep in your from their possession to kick it to you would have gave you great field position to start out. So that's a big play call.
No doubt. We'll see what happens here. Morrison looking to throw again. He's got a guy open around the 30. He catches it, gets over to the 33 before he is held up and then tackled.
Yeah, Chris Patton slipped down on that stop route, which allowed the wide receiver to have an opening on that catch.
Sebastian Cifuentes with the catch. for the Cougars. Brings it up to the 32-yard line, a third and one for Cinco Ranch. Morrison looks like he's going to take it himself. He doesn't look like he's going to get it, though. Probably still a yard shy.
And that was a nice bear crawl. I'm going to give that to Nicholas Crawford. He's actually the one that made the quarterback change directions by the bear crawl. He got through on the line. I mean, like I said, the bear crawl is a nice technique. It definitely helps you, but you know, normally you can't get your hands up, but he actually did on that play. Nice play.
Well, they're actually going to bring out the chains to measure this. Initially, where they spotted it, it looked like he was a good yard shy. This indication is going to be short, but it's still a lot closer than I thought it was going to be. And with a fourth and inches situation, does it look like they're bringing on their special teams? They made a lot of substitutions just now.
It looked like they brought a lot of size in, and maybe they're in the impression they want to attempt to go for it. I mean, you run the risk that you want to impose your will and try to jump on Mayde Creek early, but you also run the risk of, you know, kind of outthinking yourself and putting yourself in a bad position. You don't want to give Mayde Creek the ball here. Anything can happen this close to your own end. It appears they're going to their jumbo set.
Coach Clayton going for it here on fourth and inches. They're going to hand the ball off. They're going to get a first down. Johnson jumping over everybody. He's got well enough for the first down.
I mean, they came out in the diamond look formation. And it's a nice power eye type of formation. Risky, but it was a nice call to make it once they got it.
Oh, works out for Cinco Ranch, and they have a new set of downs. Morrison is going to fake a handoff, now take it himself. He's going to pick up about five on the play up to the 40-yard line, still in his own territory. Just over 4 minutes left in the first half. Second and five. To the outside, a first down. Pass midfield into Mayde Creek territory. Taking that ball was Greg Williams.
Tackled by Cameron Arredondo.
And that's a nice play hitting it to the outside. I can see the Cinco on that other side. They also see that Mayde Creek is bear crawling in the middle, trying to clog up the lane. So the easiest way to beat that is to bounce out to the outside since everyone is lock jammed in the middle.
Cinco Ranch trying to put some more points up on the board, I'm sure, before the end of the half. Morrison with the fake handoff. Now the flag is thrown as he picks up probably a yard on that play. And it's going to be holding against the offense. It'll be coming back.
Yeah, it's big Grant Mitchell, number 54, that got through the hole. It seems like they're pretty good at the bear crawl. I mean, they're very quick and agile. It is causing Cinco Ranch, the lineman, a lot of problems early just because when you bear crawl, you're so low. And it's hard for those big linemen to get as low as they are. So it's kind of giving them a little bit of some kind of discomfort early right around that line.
Coach Robbie wants an explanation as to what's going on here. It's going to go in his team's favor. That backs them up 10 yards, so it'll be first and 20 now in their own territory once again. Ball on the 44-yard line. Morrison looking downfield, now will go for a short pass, and that's completed, but for a very short amount, if he actually looks like he got any on that one.
Another nice tackle by Kevin Lasky, number 12. And that was actually a linebacker blitz. He almost got to Morrison in the backfield. Morrison just got it off in time.
Austin Fraley with the reception. Though they do lose a yard on the play. Thought maybe they had gotten back up to the line of scrimmage. So now the ball on the 43-yard line. Second and 21 coming. 2:37 and ticking left in the second quarter. Morrison going to the outside. It's completed. Just past midfield into Mayde Creek territory.
You got Chris Patton on the tackle.
Cifuentes with the reception. Now it looks like they're back up to the original line of scrimmage. Close to it.
This is a big play for Mayde Creek's defense. They want to try to get this three and out.
They've got a good shot on third and 11. Morrison's going to look downfield. The pass is complete. Now it comes loose. Now they're just going to say that he didn't have control of it. Incomplete pass will bring up fourth down and long for Cinco Ranch.
That's a big play from Mayde Creek. They're getting a lot of pressure. I'm really impressed early with the defensive line and linebackers. Of course, they're lining up in their 3-4, and it appears they're putting eight or nine guys in the box to try to attempt to stop their run. They got their defensive lineman bear crawling on the ground to plug up those holes, and they're giving a lot of pressure right now to Cinco Ranch. A lot more now, I'm sure they're expected.
It's interesting. We've seen a lot of fourth down tries here, and here's another one. Morrison on fourth and 11. We'll look downfield. He's got a guy wide open. All he had to do is catch it, and it is Mayde. A first down as that pass was completed over to Tanner Radomski.
Looked like they leaked out their big fullback out to the flats, and no one even saw him out there in the flats all by himself.
Now approaching 2 minutes left. Morrison's going to take it himself. He finds a nice hole, and Morrison gets more points on the board for Cinco Ranch. They got another touchdown, and they take a 20-7 lead.
That's a nice option read by Morrison. Fake to your tailback, of course, as you read your defensive end, defensive tackle, whoever you choose to read off of, had a wide open lane all the way to the end zone untouched. Touchdown, Cinco.
So not only do they get the conversion on fourth down the very next play, they put more points up on the board. And here for the PAT, up and good. 21 Cinco Ranch, 7 Mayde Creek. 204 is left in this first half. You are watching TexanLive.com. Well, Derek, it is a 21-7 game, and Mayde Creek look like they're trying to hang around in this game, and Cinco Ranch has pushed us a little bit more open, though still a lot of football to be played.
Yeah, it's tough. Mayde Creek is—they're giving a valiant effort so far, but they're expending a lot of energy, you know, on the defensive side. The defense has been on the field a lot tonight. The Mayde Creek offense wants to get this ball. They need to get something going again.
There's another kickoff. It's a line drive, and that's going to be taken around the 19-yard line. And now finally getting over to the 30-yard line. Looks like Joshua Griffiths was the one who took it for Mayde Creek. And Mayde Creek's got a buck 57 to try to get something going here.
Yeah, they need to try to get a first down, try to keep it going, get down as close as they can, maybe get a field goal out of it, maybe even take another shot deep. But they definitely don't want to have Cinco peel their ears back and start bringing any more pressure and trying to pin them deep.
Alcazar will hand the ball off. And a pickup of about 5 or 6 yards on that play.
Second down. Three to go.
Officially 7 yards on that gain for Mayde Creek. Clock, though, ticking. Down to 1:30. Second and three coming up. Play clock at 13. Alcazar is going to go long downfield, a good spiral, and that ball is just slightly overthrown. Its intended receiver was Shelton. Couldn't come away with that one, though. It'll be third and three. Clock stopped at 1:19.
Yeah, he put it just a little bit out of the reach of the wide receiver. Once again, Mayde Creek needs to make sure they get this first down. They don't want to give the ball back to Cinco. Cinco Ranch has got some momentum going now. They just put a touchdown on the board with their big quarterback taking it up the middle on the option read. Last thing they want to do is give Cinco Ranch any more time, though, because Cinco Ranch still has a couple timeouts to use.
That's a good point. They don't get something going here. Cinco Ranch can easily move the ball up, especially if they have urgency going. There's flags before the play with snap. So that's not going to help either. False start going against the offense. Backs him up 5 more yards, so third and 8 coming their way.
Yeah, any of the leaders, any of the captains on the Mayde Creek offense, they need to settle the group down, get them back on track again, because they need this first down.
Funny you should mention that. One of the captains just checking back into the game, Jalen Brown. Over at left out right now. Here we go, Alcazar looking downfield. He's got a man open, and he does catch. Oh, he dropped it from this angle. Looked like he had it, and as he was falling, he must have lost gripping of it or something. Never had full possession of that, and it'll go down as an incomplete pass.
Yeah, that's a nice pass up by Andrew Ugueda. It's a big play for Mayde Creek. I mean, he almost had the ball. I mean, I understand you can't catch everything, but that would have been a big first down for Mayde Creek to keep this drive going. And now the worst thing that they want to have happen, now they have to kick the ball back to Cinco with about a minute or so left and some timeouts. That's going to be tough on their defense. Their defense has been on the field for Mayde Creek most of this game.
Pfeiffer kicking himself a bit for that one. Was a tough catch. This ball is taken by, looks like, and wow, he's going to get good field position. He's still on his feet. He's over at the 10, at the 5, a touchdown for Cinco Ranch. That one's taken all the way home. Wow. Seven is the score now. That could not have gone any worse for Mayde Creek, though. Cinco Ranch in great position. Wow. Extra point, great effort to try to get and block that one, but it makes its way through the upright. So with 56 seconds until the half, it's 28 Cinco Ranch and 7 Mayde Creek. We'll be back after this on TexanLive.com. Well, there's 56 seconds left in the half. Mayde Creek was hanging tough there for a little while. 7-7 was the score. Now 21 unanswered points from Cinco Ranch have certainly opened this game up just a little bit more.
Yeah, it's always tough. I mean, there's three phases to football, as everyone knows who loves football. I mean, you have your offense, your defense, your special teams. That's actually was set up on that incompletion pass. You put it up to your special team. The momentum is all Cinco Ranch right now.
And here they are kicking off. Once again, this one's taken around the 8-yard line, finding a good hole, and now going to the outside. He's got a block. He's still on his feet on the 40 to the 45. Now over to midfield. The stiff arms keep a coming. Great run there from the return man for Mayde Creek. Sean McConico.
That was an outstanding return from Mayde Creek. No flags on the play. That's exactly the answer you want to have to try to stay in this game. You just gave up a big punt return on your end, and now you come out on your kickoff return to kind of get a little bit of that back. This is a key series. It's only 47 seconds left, but they do have a couple timeouts as well. They want to try to get something established, at least get a field goal to go in the half, have a little momentum, and feel good about yourself.
Whatever they can do, certainly with 47 seconds left, would help. McConico going to take it again. He tries to spin his way a little bit more forward. Forward motion is going to say he got about 2 yards on the play. Clock still ticking now, down to 30 seconds. Here they go, Alcazar. Looking to the outside, and he's going to overthrow his intended receiver. That one on the play, Damon Bryant. Tight end couldn't come away with that one. Well over his head. Incomplete pass, makes it 3rd and 8. Clock stopped at 22 seconds.
And that's a good thing about that. At least it was an incomplete pass for Mayde Creek. That'll give an opportunity for that clock to stop. They still have 2 timeouts. They can't take them into the locker room, so they definitely want to use that, either one now to decide what kind of play they want to get on this 3rd down, or to after they make the catch, hopefully they can use it to use that 1st down. You don't want to run out of time now, as close as you are on the other side of the field.
Whistles. Timeout is going to be taken by Mayde Creek with 21 seconds left in the first half. 28-7 game in favor of Cinco Ranch over Mayde Creek. You're watching TexanLive.com.
Come enjoy the heart of Katy, Texas, one of the most delightful cities in the Lone Star State. The best part? It's a short drive from Houston and minutes from the Energy Corridor. With places to stay and places to play, anything you'd like to eat, and an old town charm that can't be beat. Activities and fun for the entire family. Enjoy the best of both worlds in the City of Champions, Katy, Texas. For more information, go to cityofkaty.com.
Back here from the timeout, Mayde Creek wanted to talk things out. They've got a 3rd and 8 coming up. Alcazar looking downfield. He's going to go long. Pass just a bit out of the reach. Shelton was the intended receiver.
And Mayde Creek was trying to send a wide receiver up the seam. Just a little bit out of the reach of the wide receiver. And I know it's only 15 seconds left, but you want to try to do something here to get you a 1st down. As Mayde Creek, you don't want to give the ball back to Cinco and give them a couple shots at the end zone for their end. They've already got the momentum. You need to try to get something out of this possession.
So the incomplete pass makes it 4th and 8, 15 seconds left. Alcazar definitely rolling out to his right. He's got 3 wide receivers over on that side. Double coverage on the other end, and that's going to go for an incomplete pass. Would have been a miracle catch had it been made. Intended receiver once again was Shelton. And a turnover on downs, 8 seconds. We'll give it over to Cinco Ranch, and I have to imagine they'll probably just kneel on it.
Yeah, that's possible to take a knee, but if you're aggressive like most coaches are, in a situation, you want to take a shot on your end. They allowed you to stay in it with 8 seconds left. Why not take a shot deep? You're not going to hurt anything.
I suppose that would be a good situation, especially where they are right now. Perhaps if they were backed up to their own 10 or something like that, it would be a different situation. But you're right. They can actually go to the end zone right now if they wanted to try to put some more points on the board before the end of the half. Looks like that's what they'll do. They're going to have trips left. Now looking towards the end zone, here's a Hail Mary, and he's got a guy down there. The pass is actually going to be completed over by the 7-yard line. Unfortunately for them, that's going to be the end of the first half, though incredible catch and incredible play, just couldn't quite get to the end zone. So the halftime has come, 28 Cinco Ranch on top of Mayde Creek, who only have 7. Halftime brought to you by Panera Bread. We'll see you after the break and be back for the third quarter here on TexanLive.com.
At Panera, we decided a long time ago to avoid the easy road and switch to antibiotic-free chicken. That decision set a lot of things in motion. So now it's not just chickens raised this way. It's more ingredients you can trust. Which has taught us a lesson. Sometimes, what you think is the harder road turns out to be the only one worth being on. Panera Bread. Live consciously. Eat consciously.